So guys, Eugene and Compton Gardner, right here in my backyard orchard. And this is an update on my mango tree, the Alfonso mango that I dug up from my friend's house, planted it here. You can see I have this tarp creating a little canopy because when I transplanted it, all the leaves fell off and it started to die back because we got some pretty hot weather right around that time. And it was, you know, summertime when I did it, so provided this little shade canopy here. See from the inside, just to block the sun, the morning sun. But you can see how I pruned it back here, just a stick basically. And I had to cut everything off that was dying. It's only one leaf up there, but everything that was dying, had to do some major cuts. And then that black stuff is like a wound protector. Had to do all of that. But this is the month end. I did water it like every 3 days or so. Kept the soil moist. That's just eggshells and stuff that I have in the ground, scraps. But I'm excited because came out here and you can see the growth. There's about six of them, but there's one, there's two, three, four, one, two, three, four, five. Yeah, that's five down there. But the one I'm most excited about is this one here that's coming out. And the reason is because that means I don't have to cut all of this back in order to get to the living tissue here, because this one is still growing. So as long as I get more up here, I'm gonna focus all of the attention to the top here and let it grow, as opposed to having this low growth here. But I am gonna wait till I see a good amount of growth at the top and then clean everything off from the bottom here. I'm gonna use these just to get the energy back to the tree. But not gonna lie, I thought it was dead, but I did dig up a good amount of roots. I did have to cut the tap roots and stuff, so that was the scary part. But a month later and we're in good condition. This one here I think is dead already, but this one is still living, the growth there. So hopefully I get some more coming out from here. And the way you could tell if it's dead, what I did is get like a blade or so, and I just cut, like kind of cut the first layer off. And if you see green, then it's still good. But if it was brown, then I just went ahead and pruned it. So over here, this part was green, so I left it, had the one leaf there, and now it's starting to grow all of this part, right? So you'll just keep cutting back until you get to green, and then that's live tissue. This one here, all of this might be dead. See where I scraped it? Get my finger. I scraped it up here and it's brown. So this part here is gonna be dead, but I'm not gonna cut it right now because I want the energy to focus on the leaves. And that's pretty much it, just a month update. Survived Alfonso mango, and this tree here was already more than 10 years old when I dug it up. So again, my friend was living, well, he still is, he has a house in Huntington Beach, but I think that water, that salt water in the air was preventing it from fruiting, because it had been there for 10 years and no fruit. So I told him, let me have it, and he finally parted ways. And here it is in my yard now. All right, y'all have a good one.